lot of things actually motivated me and inspired me to pursue my career. One started at a very young age with my mom. She was a registered nurse. I became extremely interested in medicine and health and public health. And when I went to college and really got my feet wet in it, I really just developed that passion even deeper, and then it got more defined in chemistry. I was the first to graduate with a dance and chemistry degree at the same time. I think there's a lot of adversity that you face, especially in the fields that I decided to go into. Being a dancer and a cheerleader, you're viewed in a certain stereotypical way, and I think it's been a challenge to kind of show people that, hey, I might look or one way, or you might think I'm one way, but I've got a lot more to me than just that. I'm actually working in the tobacco analysis lab at the CDC, so I'm mainly working with different tobacco products, and we're doing research on those tobacco products to help with the exposure and to explain the exposure of tobacco, such as nicotine, the amount of tar, the amount of carbon monoxide, and even water. I think women have a very dynamic impact on public health. Women bring a whole different aspect. Women think differently than men. They're able to add that extra diversity in the way of thinking and solving issues and understanding the other aspect of the world. My words of wisdom to other women or other girls: once you set your mind to something, don't let anyone convince you otherwise. Don't let anyone tell you you're less than what you can be, and just, you know, determine what you want to be and reach that goal, and don't let anyone stop you.